When selecting a new Brompton, one major decision is the number of gears to go for. Now the Brompton has introduced its 4-speed drivetrain, there are even more options. Which one to choose? Hi, we're Pam and Gilbert. We've been touring on folding bikes for more than a decade. In this video, we'll review the gearing configurations offered by Brompton and help you identify which is right for you. Some basic explanation first. A typical bicycle drivetrain consists of a chain ring at the front, attached via the chain to a sprocket at the back. As the chain ring rotates, it makes the bicycle move forward. The distance traveled after a full rotation of the chain ring is measured in meters of development. It can be computed using the size of the chain ring, the number of teeth in the sprocket, and the tire diameter. For bicycles with an internal hub, the hub ratio is also factored in. In some areas of the world, the term gear inch is preferred, which measures a similar attribute in different units. On a flat road, a commuter would commonly use a 50 to 60 gear inch or 4 to 4.8 meters of development range. For hill climbing, the low gear setting should be around half that value. Alternatively, high-speed rides would require gears in the 100 gear inch or 8 meters of development range. Therefore, a 400% ratio between the lowest and highest gears makes an excellent range for a multi-purpose bike. For example, a typical full-size hybrid bike, the Trek FX3 with its 40-teeth chainring and 10-speed cassette, has a range of 418%. A road bike like the specialized Allez Sport has a similar range, but skewed toward higher speeds. Its dual chainring and 9-speed cassette provide a narrower gap between gears, ensuring better cadence optimization than a hybrid bicycle. In comparison, a similarly priced city bike like the Gazelle Chamonix with its 8-speed Shimano internal hub has a narrower range at 307%, which misses the lower and higher gears found on bikes that focus on speed or climbing. Let's look at how the range is available on various Brompton options compared to these hybrid road and city bikes. Brompton offers 3 basic chainring sizes, 44 teeth, 50 teeth, and 54 teeth, as well as 5 different gearing configurations, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6 speeds. The only single-speed Brompton now offered is the T-Line. With its specially designed carbon 50-teeth chainring, it has only one chainring configuration. With 69 gear inches or 5.6 meters of development, this premium ultralight bicycle is particularly appropriate as a quick multimodal commuter in a relatively flat environment. The 2-speed Brompton, or C-Urban, is offered with the 50 and 54-teeth chainrings, although a 44-teeth could be installed as an aftermarket upgrade. The gearing range is quite narrow at 133%, but as the name implies, it will do a good job in an urban environment. The Brompton 3-speed uses a Sturmey Archer standard range internal hub. It's less efficient and heavier than a Dreyer-based system, but is more robust. The gears are equally spaced at 33%. The A-Line, the less expensive bike, is only offered with a 44-teeth chainring, while the C-Line utility is offered with all 3 chainring options, the 50 being the default value. Both offer a total range of 177%. The newly introduced Dreyer-based 4-speed is available in both P-Line and T-Line. While only the 50-teeth chainring can be ordered for the T-Line, a 54-teeth option is available for the P-Line. Surprisingly, its 164% range is smaller than the 3-speed models. It's lighter and more efficient, however, and has smaller increments between gears. It's an interesting option for a high-performance Brompton if money is no object. Finally, the 6-speed C-Explore is built around a hybrid drivetrain combining a proprietary wider range internal hub and 2 rear sprockets. It provides a wider range, 302%, with increments of 22 and 27% between gears. While the standard chainring is 50 teeth, those planning on long-distance touring would appreciate the 44-teeth chainring option instead, which provides an acceptable 29 gear inches or 2.3 meters of development in first gear. This is the configuration that we selected for our 6-speed Bromptons. When making the Brompton gear decision, a couple of important questions are: how fast can it go? And can it climb hills? Ultimately, it's more the rider's fitness than the gearing that determines speed. Assuming a rather casual cadence between 60 and 80 RPM, here's the associated speed for each gearing configuration. For example, our Brompton's fifth gear would translate to 24 kilometers per hour at 70 RPM, a similar speed and cadence to the T-Line's one speed. Also, notice how the 4 and 6 speed ranges slightly overlap, enabling the rider to better adapt the preferred cadence to road and weather conditions. To evaluate climbing performance, we need to factor in the slope gradient and the maximum sustainable power a cyclist can generate. Slope gradient is usually computed in percent. It's basically the elevation gain divided by the distance traveled. The famous French Tourmalet, for example, is about 20 kilometers long with an elevation gain of 1,400 meters for an average 7% grade. Of course, the maximum power generated varies from one cyclist to another. According to research performed by NASA, an average fit man could be expected to generate a maximum of 200 watts for 1 hour. This can increase to about 500 watts for 30 seconds effort. Therefore, a 70 kilogram rider cycling at 60 RPM could expect the following results. A cyclist riding a T-Line 1 speed up a 10% hill would be exhausted after only 30 seconds. The same rider on a 6-speed C-Line Explore would be able to sustain a similar cadence for more than 25 minutes. Replacing the 50-teeth chainring with a 44-teeth would almost double that time to 45 minutes. By staying in first gear, our typical cyclist using a C-Line Explore should be able to climb a 30 kilometer 4.5% grade in about 4 hours for a total of 1,500 meters elevation gain. If the bicycle is fully loaded, the expected elevation gain after 4 hours would be reduced to about 1,000 meters. Climbing power like speed will vary significantly depending on fitness level, but the mechanical advantage provided by lower gears is a key factor. Is there a simple answer to which gearing configuration to choose? Well, it depends on intended use as well as budget. If you plan to climb hills or do long distance touring, the 6-speed Explorer with a 44-teeth chainring is the ideal choice. If price is the principal motivator, the A-Line offers the best deal. The commuting cyclist with a large wallet will focus on the T-Line, whose lightweight makes for ideal multimodal use. The C-Line Urban offers a better price-to-weight ratio for those who cannot afford or justify a T-Line. For performance riding, we give the nudge to the P-Line. Although it is heavier than the T-Line, it offers a better chainring selection and is thus better suited to a faster rider. Finally, the C-Utility, with its robust 3-speed Sturmey Archer internal hub, will likely require less maintenance than the other models. But because it's only 300 grams lighter than the 6-speed, we would probably suggest an upgrade to the Explore. Either that or save 33% and go for the A-Line. We hope that your gearing decision gets you the best cycling experience that your money can buy.